Well, I hope you've got your popcorn ready. Welcome to the Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games. It's day six of the speed skating competition and the last day of action in the speed skating at the James Sheffield Olympic Skating Rink. Today, it's all about the mass start events. We'll start with the women's race, which has 24 athletes competing in it, and they'll complete 16 laps of the 400-meter oval. A slightly delayed start, but Suzanne there in the white coat and her team have done a fantastic job of clearing the snow off this 400-meter oval. And the mass start can get a little complicated, but let's start with the easy thing. You cross the line first after 16 laps, you're going to get the gold medal. Second and third also will be on the podium, but there are some intermediate sprint laps where athletes can gain points. Laps 4, 8 and 12. You cross the line in first, you get 3 points. Second, you get 2, and third, you'll get 1 point. And those points are really important for the places outside the top three. Athletes coming out of the warm hut in preparation for the race. There are a few to look out for as well. Park Ji-woo from Korea. She's taking gold in the 1500, silver in the 3000, and in the pursuit. Top of the pile, Natalia Jabric. Number one cap. She's taken that 1500 meter silver in the pursuit gold, so another one to look out for. A couple of Canadians too. Roseanne Grenier wearing number 3 and Laura Ann Hall with the 206 on her cap. Those two all taking gold in the 3000. Grenier bronze. They could be in the mix. And Antosova from the Czech Republic, the only Czech Republic athlete in the field with helmet number 2. Good conditions now. It was a little bit gloomy. We've had a big dump of snow overnight, probably about 4 or 5 inches, and had to bring in a second Zamboni to clear the ice. So Natalia Jabric lined up next to Veronika Antsova. Roseanne Grenier on the front line as well. And they get underway.
Now introducing the rest of the field.
And immediately you see Hall just having a look on the inside. The 206 couch sitting in seventh position at the moment.
Shino Misaki, helmet 9 from Poland. Federica Mafia, helmet number 210 from the Czech Republic. Olga Kaczmarek, helmet number 211
Jabric
from Kazakhstan.
At the front.
Helmet number 12,
taking
from
it
Norway,
easy at the moment.
Arina Ilyichenko.
So about positioning 13, for
Julia
lap
Hirsch
number
Schoenberg.
4.
Helmet number 14 from the USA. Thalia Staley. Helmet number 14 from the Netherlands. Julin Minsu de Visser.
Ryan Hall just sitting around the outside here. Now the speed goes up as they prepare for the first set of points available in this mass start. Now, Jabric moving to the front. Looks like Jabric has taken the first set of points. Got tight at the end there. Jostling for position, creating this aerodynamically efficient train. As they go through the end of lap 7, they get the bell, and we have another sprint on our hands. Kosovo is up the front. And she's managed to hold that position. She was there before, but didn't end up with any points. And now you see that she's been dropped. And it's Günther who's pressed to the front. But then a quick move from Veronika Antisova. Pechnik also in the hunt for points here, but back up to the front. It's the Canadian now. So Hall taking the points. Hall from Canada, the gold medalist in the 3,000 meters, taking the points on lap 8. So now they start the push to the final lap. There's a Günther who took the points in the intermediate from Merckx and Kurseva. But now the race to the finish begins. Roseanne Grenier moving up front from teammate Laura Ann Hall. Trying to just break the train up a little bit, but it hasn't happened. They've just eased off again. So Hall leading the way. Sjöbrand was in the mix there as we go into our next sprint. And Natalia Jabric up at the front now, pushing hard. And it is Pechnik from Austria who has taken the points from Jabric. And Antisova in the mix as well, too. Well, 3 points for her in the sprints. So now we have the push to the finish. Sjöbrand from Norway making a break here. She's pushed really hard now. Do we have a four there? Well, Sjöbrand has really broken open the path here. Leading from Jabric and Pechnik. But look how far ahead she is. She's gone 20 meters clear, Sjöbrand. Juliberg Sjöbrand, I should say. Coming up to the line to complete lap number 14. So Sjöbrand miles ahead. Fast lap of 32:36. And chasing it down, that is the intermediate sprint results. After the three sprints, those are the points that will be gained by Jabric, Merckx and Günther at the top of the pile. Now, a real push here from Roseanne Grenier. And they've hauled in Sjöbrand. Grenier leading up the front, and Takahashi, who took the gold medal here at the test event, presses on to the front of the pack. Takahashi working hard in front of her Japanese teammate, Shino. So we sprint through now to the medals, and crossing the line, it is Shino Misaki ahead of her teammate Takahashi Yuka, and in the end it was Josephine Hamrell who made it through in third position for Germany. But what a sprint from Shino Misaki at the end there. Here is the break from Sjobren from Norway. She really went out hard. Here come the Japanese athletes taking over from Roseanne Grenier of Canada, and the sprint to the finish. Well, in the end, Grenier didn't have enough and got pipped on the post by the two Japanese athletes and by Heimel of Germany.
From Germany, Josephine
Vietz. Look at the delight. Shino and Takahashi, first and second for Japan. Can't quite believe it. Congratulations coming in from Heimel, who took third place for Germany. Confirmation of the remaining places. Park Ji-woo collecting 10 points for finishing fourth. Does finish fourth overall from Italy's Federica Maffei. And as you can see here, Abigail Merckx of Hungary with 3 points from the last sprint, the final sprint. Well, the men's mass start consists of 24 athletes. A few to look out for at the top of the order. Arito Matanaga from Japan, LaRue from Canada, and Di Stefano from Italy all have already medaled here. We've actually had a few knocked out here. Harris from Great Britain, Barakles from Switzerland, and Bodai from Hungary all electing not to take part. So just 20 runners in this. And the men's mass start is underway.
Seven from Korea, Chung Yang-gun, helmet 8 from France, Matthew Bellour, helmet 9 from Poland, Jackie Jatrowski, helmet 10 from Kazakhstan, Bakhtalay Sagotov, helmet number 11 from the USA, Tommy Fitzgerald,
leading the way.
Italy, helmet 212, Ricardo Lorello, helmet number 13 from Spain, Manuel Rola. Helmet 214 from Spain, Alexander Resnico. Helmet 15 from Norway, Joran Antoine Slekin. Helmet number 216 from Hungary, Balak Bole. Helmet number 17 from Switzerland, Thibaut Metro. Helmet 18 from Germany, Leonard Norman Yash. Helmet number 219 from Kazakhstan, Andrei Zuev. Helmet 220
so
from
pushing
Poland,
early
Kara
here.
Karczewski. Helmet number 221 from Switzerland, Dietrich Vercles. Helmet 222 from France.
Polish athlete taking to the front of the field.
Great Britain, Jocko Veldman. Helmet number 225 from Norway, Daniel Tuve Eriksson.
Pushing out early, very hard.
From Japan, Yanagaki Yuto.
Getting the bell at the end of the third lap. Karczewski pushing hard. Now Sagatov and Zuev are two Kazakh athletes in the hunt for points here.
Stay right on each other's hip to break the speed. Our first sprint points are going to go to Karczewski. 3 points for the sprint unofficially. Looks like he's going to let
so Karczewski from Sagatov and Varikles getting the points in the first sprint.
As you can imagine, a lot of strategy in this race, deciding who's going to pull. There are teams out there. You see the team from Italy.
So Lorello, the 5,000 meter gold medalist, leading an Italian 1-2.
It's been just incredible for everyone that's been part of this. We're coming out to lap 9.
Tanigaki Yuto, who is
we have
in the mix as well at the moment.
Medalist in this group from this week.
taking to the front. As they get the belt on this sprint lap. Barraclis from Switzerland, and that is the number 10 from Kazakhstan who's gone down. Dulet Sagatov. Falling way off the back here.
And again, this is a sprint point. 3, 2, 1.
Chasing down the points here in the second intermediate sprint. It's the Hungarian who's stepped up and taken the points. Besci from Lorello, from Di Stefano. One more intermediate sprint at lap 12. But as you can see, the three leaders, well, in fact, four leaders, are just trying to split the field up a little bit. Fitzgerald pushing hard at the front, but Yash took lap 10 from Lorello and Di Stefano. Fitzgerald now pressing out at the front. Now, an early break from the American, Thomas Fitzgerald.
It's the American, Tommy Fitzgerald.
And into the final sprint here. Fitzgerald breaks the line first, leading out and pushing hard. Yash in second. Sneaky from Norway got into the mix there, but he's been pushed back out again. And this time, the Italians again pushing for position here. So Fitzgerald, Yash and Di Stefano taking the sprint points in the final intermediate sprint. So Arito will cross the line to complete lap 14, and he's saying, well, now it's time for me to show you what can be done over the last 800 meters. Now Arito is trying to hold on here, and the Canadian has stepped up into the mix. Well, this is getting super fast. The Canadian's gone up front, and a big fall there as well. This is huge. The Canadian waiting for the last minute and crosses the line in first place. What a brilliant sprint finish from David LaRue, taking out Daniel Di Stefano for second place. The Italian was in the front for most of the race, and Hubert Marcotti is the provisional bronze medal finisher. It was a good 1,000 meters to go when Arito pressed the accelerator. And then it was just a slip from Arito in his efforts to haul in David LaRue that had overtaken him on the outside. But David LaRue picked his moment to take the sprint. And here are the final standings. David LaRue from Canada taking gold, his second individual gold here at the competition. From Daniele Di Stefano of Italy in second place, and Hubert Marcotti of Canada taking a second medal for the Canadian team.
Thank you.
mascots will be presented by Jackie Kelly, the Lake Placid Village Trustee. Third place, representing Germany, Josephine Viette-Hemmerl.
So Josephine Hemmerl from Germany taking the bronze medal, representing not only her country, but the IUBH International Hoche School. She got a silver in the test event last year.
Second place, representing Japan,
here,
Takahashi Yuka.
The gold medalist from the test event, Takahashi Yuka from Japan, had to settle for second place, represents Japan and Daito Bunker University.
First place, and the women's mass start champion, representing Japan, Shino Misaki.
Well, it was a brilliant sprint finish to take this gold medal, and it also goes to Japan's Shino Misaki, student at the
Lake
Nippon
Placid
Sports Science University.
Izu World University Games winner.
Their confirmation, Shino Misaki at the top of a Japanese 1-2, Takahashi Yuka in second place, and Josephine Hemmerl from Germany with the bronze medal.
The men's mass
this
start.
Is the last of the action from the speed skating competition.
Please welcome the winners.
At the Lake Placid 2023 World University Games.
The mascots will be presented by Jackie Kelly, Lake Placid Village Trustee. Third place, representing Canada, Hubert Marco.
Well, Hubert Marco was absolutely superb. He was very happy to sit back. I think coming through lap 10 in ninth place, and after lap 13, he was 13th. But what a sprint finish over the last 800
second
to
place,
take
representing
the
Italy,
bronze medal for Canada.
Daniele Di Stefano.
Now, Di Stefano had a completely different race up the front from the start. Never out of the top six, but he put on a brilliant 400 meters to finish off in
first
silver
place,
medal for
and
Italy.
The men's mass start champion representing Canada, David LaRue.
But David LaRue, superb performance, hanging in the main pack for 14 laps before blasting the last 800 meters to become the champion,
the
taking gold for Canada. So LaRue from Di Stefano and Marcotti, a brilliant finish for the Canadians, with Italy sandwiched in the middle.